I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with your feeder flash for Tuesday, May the 22nd, where we got a short reprieve anyway to start the week this week, which is kind of nice to start the week, if not a positive note, but something besides sharply lower. And I don't really think it's going to last very long, but there's just too much pressure on everything. But there was some technical support if you looked at the charts, and as hard as the board's been down last week, we probably had a little room to bounce back, but still a lot more pressure on the board and a lot farther to fall. But you look at the board on Monday, June live cattle futures up $2.52 to end the day at 104.92, kind of taking back some of that basis that the guys have been enjoying but knew needed to get a little bit closer as we get closer to June. Your August up $2.40 at $100.62, which it always makes you feel better whenever that out front live cattle board is above a dollar. August feeder cattle up $2.87 to end the day at 140.5, and your May spot feeders up 170 to end the day at 133.92. Your fat cattle trade for last week in five area feeding region ended up with 96,700 head, so a good movement. But if you asked anybody what the price was, you know, normally in your negotiated fat cattle market, you have one number that's the number, especially on a live basis. And I'm not sure if we ever really found that number. Probably 114 was the closest thing we got to it, and 182 or 3 dress late in the week. But your weighted average in your five area feeding region was actually a little better than that, because we had some early trade, if you remember. But on live steers, 114.73 was your weighted average price. Now that includes a lot of cattle trading for the 2 to 4 week delivery, if not the immediate delivery, and cattle traded every day of the week. But that weighted average mark was almost $7 lower than the weighted average the previous week. In fact, it was $6.92 lower. Your dress steers averaged 184.02, which would have been $7.97 lower than the weighted average from the previous week. But I know we said 96,700 head in your five area feeding region. Nationwide, we sold 107,500 head negotiated. And we've been talking about those cattle that were for immediate delivery or within the next 2 weeks, which normally that's what you consider current delivery. But we also include in that negotiated trade the 2 to 4 week delivery cattle. And like we've talked day after day here, we've had a lot more of those in recent weeks than we've ever had since they've been keeping track of that data. And it's been running about 30% of the weekly volume. Last week it ran 48% of your weekly volume. So of that 107,500 head that sold negotiated nationwide, only 52% of them were for immediate or the next 2 week delivery. So I think the packers are really going to like this. They're gonna keep the negotiated trade kind of watered down and spread out as long as they can coax guys into selling the cattle 2 to 4 weeks down the road. It's kind of, like I said, messed up where we don't really know exactly where the market's at, which confusion is always a good thing when you're trying to buy. And it's potentially going to mess up your formula deals. I know we've got the lion's share of your fat cattle sellers, especially the corporates. They choose to sell on a formulated basis, whether they get the high for the previous week or the weighted average or what have you, some kind of a formula, and it's usually always based off of last week's market. Well, everything's great as long as they get the full extent of the market just a week later. But whenever we get into a situation like we had last week, it kind of messes things up. There might not have been enough volume at any of those highs for the week to keep your guys that usually sell high for the previous week happy. The weighted average actually turned out to be pretty good with some higher sales earlier in the week, but we go into a week like we're going into now, and we're going to lose some more ground this week. There's no way we're not going to lose it. I'd say we'll probably end up somewhere around $1.10 for your trade this week, if we can find one number that really handles the majority of the trade. But I don't know, we're getting into a slippery slope here. No more negotiated trade as we have. We got about as much leverage as a wet noodle, and it's not looking real good for the short-term future here. Box beef cutout values have definitely leveled off and have started going down now, so we've seen the highs for them on this initial early summer springboard that they always have for the grilling season. But you look at our grain markets, rolling along pretty good, and the kind of equipment they use now, when they unfold those things and go to town, they can do a lot of work. But your corn planted acres, 82% have been planted compared to 81% same time a year ago. 51% of your corn acres have emerged now. Beans, we've planted 50% of those compared to 56% same time last year, and 17% of those beans have emerged. Look at your feeder cattle markets, your real-time index on Beef Market Central there, lagging behind things at 125.13. Your CME index just really amazingly holding up there, because there have been a lot of cattle sell off the market last week, and then a lot of those direct sales that went in there were sub 130, but still holding up there at 133.63, which is real close to what our national steer tracker is, and that's for the bigger groups that sold just on Monday, and that was 133.45. So your Oklahoma City National Stockyards market there, 9,300 head. Feeder steers there steady to just $2 lower, and a lot of steady, especially early in the day. Much lower undertone on calves, but not a real good test. But if you look at that market, it's actually better than the late week sales last week, because a lot of those Thursday, Friday sales last week were as much as $10 lower. Well, Oklahoma City wasn't near that much lower a week ago Monday, and just mostly steady to $2 lower this Monday. So actually a better market that we've seen around. You look at Joplin Regional Stockyard, 6,400 head there. They did note that they're going to be closed Memorial Day next Monday. They don't always close, but they are this Monday. Feeder steers there steady to $3 lower. Other classes of calves and feeder heifers selling $2 to $5 lower. But I'm going to give you several individual quotes, because we're really looking for a market. I know we don't have a way to find out what the fat cattle market truly is, but we can find the market on feeder cattle because we have a lot of competition. But look at our nation's feeder cattle market in Oklahoma City on Monday. National Livestock sold 85 head of 725 pound steers at $1.40. And then on some bigger steers, National sold 100 head of 861 pound steers at $1.30. So you kind of wash those together and find out what an 800 pound steer is, and that's pretty close to what we're looking at right now. Joplin Regional Stockyards might have had the most impressive price that I saw, 112 head of 1,022 pound steers that have been struggling in the teens most everywhere you see them, even in the northern plains, sold at $1.21, and they were just cattle. I mean, they couldn't walk and talk or anything, but they're good commodity cattle. But it was good to see some demand for great big steers like that. I want to go out east again and show you how well cattle are selling out there. Bluegrass Stockyards in Stanford, Kentucky sold three loads of steers, sold in load lots on Monday, 850 to 900 pound steers. They bring from 134.75 to 137.80. And then talked to a guy there, Wesley, at in the management of Montgomery Stockyards in Montgomery, Alabama. They had a board sale there on Monday and sold three loads of steers, weighed 8 1/4 at 132.75, and that'd be in the deep south, my friends. But that's your feeder flash for Tuesday.